私にできることございますか?
Oh, now I can look around here. You're really cute. Your face is a little chubby, though.
What?
Why would he say that? In zero gravity, your blood collects in the upper half of your body, causing your face to swell a little. It's called moon face. I think I'm gonna enjoy my trip if there are girls as beautiful as you there. I'm flattered. Let's look at other stuff. You can look at her ribbon. Your uniform is a nice color. It really brings out your curves, too. You may not know that we wear a rubber undershirt, too. It helps prevent the muscles from atrophying in zero gravity. It's pretty interesting, a space stewardess. Contrary to its appearance, this is an excellent material for zero gravity. It doesn't feel very comfortable, though. As long as it looks good. As long as it looks good, Jonathan says. That's a really tight skirt. Dad, your wife just died. This is a special skirt designed to prevent SAS. It works just like my shirt. It puts pressure on the abdomen to prevent excess blood from moving to the upper half of the body as much as possible. Our entire uniform is designed this way. We also wear elastic stockings to help simulate blood flow to our legs. You have exquisite legs. Thank you, but in zero gravity, the legs appear thinner than normal because your blood collects in the upper half of your body. It's called bird leg. Is that true? Oh my god, we can touch? You really do have nice legs. I could see you're one of those smooth talkers. Would it bother you if I touched your leg? Ah, get your hands off me. You're starting to take a hands-on approach to learning about the effects of zero gravity, that's all. Sounds like something Steve Buscemi would say. You pervert! Anything else to look at? These displays here? There's a monitor on the back of every seat. We're showing news from BBC right now. If you want to watch TV, you can press the button on the wall there. Thanks. I guess she's gonna wonder now if he wants some porn. That's the monitor attached to every seat. I guess here is the same. Oh, that's an explanation of the emergency life pod. Please be sure to go over it. A life pod? Is that like a survival ball? No, a life pod has room for 30 people. In the event we have to use a life pod, remember that you would be putting on your spacesuit first. Those are stored up above. The life pod is only there in case of an emergency. Try to relax and enjoy the flight. Okay, what about these tracks? Is there anything to these? We store spacesuits for everyone in there. They're designed to open in the event of an emergency. Okay, so they're little narrow cubbies then. There's no need to worry. The apartments will only open in an emergency. Emergency? You mean when we use a life pod? Don't worry. A life pod has only ever been used once. He's already been in an accident. He's probably waiting for lightning to strike twice. Alright, so we'll talk to her. Oh! I didn't even mean to hit there. There's a separate area to look here. Oh, are you not wearing a bra? They look so perky. I think that's because the gravity it goes to, or the whatever pressure goes to the top of your body. That's right, you don't need a bra in zero gravity, nor do you need to worry about your hips, breasts, or cheeks sagging. Yeah, I see what you mean. Please don't look at me like that. You know, I don't think I've ever felt a pair in zero gravity before. Oh my god, what? What are you doing? Oh my god, he's as bad as Gillian Seed, or worse. Gillian Seed didn't touch, I don't think. He just tried to persuade and stuff. This would really, really help my SAS. Stop that, or we'll throw you off the flight. You're gonna space me? I doubt they'd do that. Miss? What do you need? Sorry, can I ask you to make it quick? Can I assist you with anything else? Can you stay a little longer? Alright. Alright, never mind. Ask about Beyond. Beyond Coast, mankind's first space colony, was completed in 2010. Since immigration was open to the general public in 2013, the colony's population has grown to approximately 1 million people. Nearly one-third of its current population is made up of second-generation inhabitants. Size? Well, first of all, the colony is a cylinder type. It's 6.5 kilometers in diameter and 32 kilometers in length. That's more. Wasn't it 20 before? It makes one complete rotation every 2 minutes, creating artificial gravity virtually equal to that of Earth's 1G. The colony's surfaces and mirrors are divided into three sections around its central axis, with each section having an area of 90 square kilometers. It's the first and only O'Neill-type colony. I can go over it again, sure, I was going to say the same thing. She can talk to us a lot about a lot of stuff here. Distance. Beyond isn't as far from Earth as some people think. It's approximately 380,000 kilometers from Earth, which is about the same as the distance between Earth and the Moon. Climate. That's what people tend to be most curious about. By changing the angles of its three solar mirrors, Beyond is able to create the effect of a day-night cycle and maintain a comfortable temperature year-round. Its climate is virtually identical to that of the west coast of the United States. That's the other reason it's called Beyond Coast. Environment. Its environment isn't as alien as some people expect. It's an almost perfect recreation of Earth's. It has artificial clouds, various forms of precipitation, and even wind as well. The partial pressures of the oxygen and carbon dioxide in its atmosphere are also the same, though the partial pressure of the nitrogen is reduced by half to lower the risk of fire. Okay, SAS. The medical definition of space adaptation syndrome, or SAS, is the symptoms one experiences during adaptation to zero gravity. It varies from person to person, but over 50% of people develop symptoms within 1 to 2 hours of entering weightlessness. Much was revealed about the nature of SAS around the turn of the century. The previously held barony theory was rejected, with the cause of SAS now said to be a vestibular disorder. The vestibular system undergoes a paralysis throwing off one's center of balance. It's called the vestibular disorder theory. It states that several organs that perceive gravity are involved in this disruption, not just the otoliths of the inner ear. Treatment? Generally speaking, the most effective form of treatment would be to give an intramuscular injection of promethazine, but because SAS varies from person to person, there are currently no medications capable of alleviating all symptoms. While it's somewhat rudimentary, keeping your head as still as possible will reduce a lot of the discomfort. Symptoms include dizziness, cold sweats, vomiting, headache, and fatigue, and are often accompanied by a false feeling of falling over that doesn't occur in normal motion sickness. The longest they last is about 2 days, however, so you should be fine by the time you arrive. 2 days. Must feel like an eternity. Zero gravity's effects. There is no hydrostatic pressure in zero gravity, so much of your bodily fluids collect in the upper half of your body as it attempts to evenly distribute them. When this happens, your body then thinks the amount of blood in the bloodstream has increased, causing the brain to send a message to the kidneys. Basically, you end up having to urinate more often. I wonder if that's true. There are efforts underway to try and control this misperception in the brain through methods like biofeedback and yoga. Yoga. I think she just repeats. Oh, no, she has more. Also, because your bones, joints, and muscles don't undergo any stress in zero gravity, your bone cells lose calcium. Long-distance spaceships create artificial gravity through centrifugal force, but the only thing you can do to prevent calcium loss on this type of plane is exercise. We have equipment such as ergometers, treadmills, and resistance bands on board. You could also try chewing some gum made from the leaf of the hardy rubber tree. It's very good for your bones. I don't suppose that's the leaf that we got as evidence, do we? If it's bothering you that much, do you want to take something for it? So she goes over it. The other thing she said was more about it. For terrestrials, it might be helpful to do some zero-gravity sensory training on an adaptation training unit before you fly. Explain again. So some things she repeats and some she adds additional. Additional info. I think we read that already, though. I'll explain again. Alright. The plane. Course. Normally, we'd spend the night in an Earth-orbiting space station and then travel the rest of the way in an orbital transfer vehicle. But this is a direct flight to beyond, which takes about 2 days. Toilets. In accordance with stricter space debris regulations, the plane doesn't eject waste out into space like before, so you won't get the chance to see any space fireflies like Project Mercury's astronaut Glenn, or Milky Ways like Aurora 7's astronaut Carpenter. Is that a product of waste or something? The toilet uses a vacuum waste collection system, so it might feel a little ticklish. Ticklish? Jonathan says, I see that part hasn't changed. Meals? Space food has vastly improved over the years, and it's actually quite tasty now. Following the latest trends on Earth, we even offer Japanese cuisine as well. However, because food doesn't taste as good in low air pressure environments, we don't bother using any exotic flavorings. Well, that's a shame. Remember I was talking about the effects of zero gravity a moment ago? Space travel also causes changes in your body's internal secretions and metabolism, which can further affect your sense of taste. So you may not be completely satisfied with certain aspects of the food, but we ask for your understanding. Yeah, it's literally it's you, not them. Passengers. The fuel tank, which contains liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen, is considerably big, so there's only enough seating space for 30 people, including crew. That's why the life pod holds exactly 30, huh? Since there are less than 30 passengers, there are no separate classes on the plane. Fuselage. I've noticed it's extremely quiet on board. She says the walls of the plane are reinforced with piezoelectric elements. Piezoelectric? Piezoelectric? I don't know if I'm saying that right. They cancel out the noise from the plane by bending in the opposite direction of the vibrations outside. That's why it was so quiet when we were leaving the atmosphere, was it? That's what he says. The exterior of the plane is covered with optical fiber. Should any problem occur outside, we'll know right away. World of difference from the shuttles we had 30 years ago, Jonathan says. She says sensors on the outside of the plane check for any changes in conditions like pressure or temperature and make automatic adjustments to the plane's course. The plane, unlike a conventional airplane, is a flat lifting body. Jonathan says, yeah, the actual plane itself creates lift, not just the wings, right? Yes, that's why the wings are so small. I know a little bit about the old shuttles myself, Jonathan says. All space planes are lifting bodies. I think he'd like to lift her body. Huh. Arrival time? So that's all for the plane, right? Arrival time. How much longer will it be until we arrive? We still have a long way to go yet. Just try to relax and enjoy the flight. How about now? There's no need to worry. We'll get there in one piece, I promise. Please just relax. You think you could give me something for my SAS? It must be really uncomfortable for you, but these things do take a while to take effect, you know. You might not need it in a little bit. Yeah, I know, but I'd still rather take something. You don't seem very sick to me, my perverted little friend. Is that because I did certain things? Take the medicine! Here is a Relax Effects, then. Relax Effects? Who makes this? Let me guess, Takugawa Pharmaceuticals. Oh, really? Thanks. Here goes nothing. I think you'll start to feel better very soon. So you would like another? Here you go. Thanks. Let me try one more. Last one, promise. Taking any more than that isn't good for you. You shouldn't take any more at once. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that, but I was going to. If you're free, how about showing a stranger around beyond, he says. Sorry, but I wouldn't feel comfortable around a pervert like you. How does you and me having dinner under the stars after we land sound? I'm sorry, but I'd rather not. Not with you, anyway. Please stop trying to ask me out. Oh, I can't. The flirt option is gone. Let's show her the Hojo photo. You ever seen the man in this photo before? I'm sorry, I don't know either of them. Lorraine's photo? What do you think of this picture? Wow, she's beautiful. I can't believe you're trying to ask me out when you got someone like that. This is a photo of me and Lorraine from when we went to Lucas World. The one I had sitting on my desk back in my office. Never hurts to think ahead. She's a very beautiful woman. Capsules? You ever seen capsules like these before? Taking that many pills at once can't be good for your body. What about the leaf? Any idea what kind of leaf this is? It doesn't look familiar now. Don't forget that if you're taking plants into beyond, they need to be inspected at the spaceport. Is that a pressed leaf from Earth? Policenauts photo. You recognize this photo? Yes, I've seen it in textbooks. They were Beyond's original cops. You're going to Beyond to learn about this Policenauts, aren't you? There's an exhibit on the Policenauts at the Astronauts Memorial Museum. I'm not going to tell her we're one of the Policenauts. Guess not. Let her go. Thanks a lot. Be good now. So we go back to talking to this guy? You seem to be apprehensive about going to Beyond, Redwood says. No, not really. You'll be fine when you get there. There's artificial gravity and nice clean air. It truly is a wonderful place. I'm sure you'll have a great time. Okay, so I hit call by mistake, I think. Oh. Turn on TV. Before I do that. Oh, what's this? Is this something different? This little thing? No. Look outside. Remarkable, isn't it? An emotionless vacuum in which only the tiniest of organisms can survive. Oh yeah, the tardigrade or whatever. I don't think we knew about that in 96, did we? Moving your head a lot will only make your SAS worse. The stewardess said the same thing, remember? Beyond is still quite a distance away. Unlike an airplane, out here looking out the window doesn't help pass the time much. Actually, surprised they even have windows, but... That is an air circulator. When you go to sleep in zero gravity, the carbon dioxide you exhale collects around your head, which can make it difficult to breathe. This device creates an airflow to prevent that. Yeah, it's probably true. It's different from an air conditioner. Yeah, really. Alright, before we talk to him, let's turn on the TV. The stewardess said I should try watching some TV, didn't she? Let's see what's on the tube. BBC News Order.
こんにちは。ニュースオーダーの時間です。
スキャンライン。
現在、ビヨンド内でのナーク中毒者が急増しております。事態を重く見た BCP では、ビヨンドでのナーク根絶を図るため、特別チームを編成。ホームからのナーク流入ルートの解明を急いでいるとのことです。ナークはアヘンから作られる合成麻薬で、モルヒネ型依存症状と LSD などの幻覚誘発症状をも兼ね備えた麻薬の帝王と言われるものです。
Damn.
宇宙推進事業団によりますと、宇宙開発におけるナークの依存度は 30% を超えると報告されており、宇宙でのナーク中毒者は増加の傾向にあるとの見解に達しております。
That's a lot.
以上、カレン北条がお伝えしました。
So, any relation to Lorraine's ex or dead husband?
BBC? どこのテレビ局だろう。
今のはビヨンドのテレビ番組ですよ。ビヨンドコーストブロードキャスティング、つまり BBC ね。
Okay, I was wondering.Anything else? Let's see what else they're showing. Yeah, Hojo. Not the same name.
それでは次のニュース。今、全世界的に移植用臓器が不足しています。
Organ shortage?
宇宙開発における宇宙環境の影響により、人体への様々な障害が起こっています。無重力状態や宇宙船などにより、臓器の疾患、異常が急増しており、このままでは十分な移植が賄えないと、ドナー不足に対する大きな不安が寄せられています。宇宙推進事業団では、ホームの移植後進国などにドナーネットワークへの加入を呼びかけています。
Hmm.
以上、BBC からお伝えしました。
It sure has.How many news articles is there? Let's see what else they're showing.
もう一度お伝えします。今、全世界的に移植用臓器が不足しています。宇宙開発における宇宙環境の影響により、人体への様々な障害が起こっています。無重力状態や宇宙船などにより臓器の疾患、異常が急増しており、このままでは十分な移植が賄えないと、ドナー不足に対する大きな不安が寄せられています。宇宙推進事業団では、ホームの移植後進国などにドナーネットワークへの加入を呼びかけています。以上、カレン北条がお伝えしました。
Did she add anything to that? It was just worded differently. Redwood says, had enough? I guess not. Let me see if there's anything different.
Genzai, Beyond 内でのナーク中毒者が急増しております。事態を重く見た BCP では、Beyond でのナーク根絶を図るため、特別チームを編成。ホームからのナーク流入ルートの解明を急いでいるとのことです。ナークはアヘンから作られる合成麻薬で、モルヒネ型依存症状と LSD などの幻覚誘発症状をも兼ね備えた麻薬の帝王と言われるものです。宇宙推進事業団によりますと、宇宙開発におけるナークの依存度は 30% を超えると報告されており、宇宙でのナーク中毒者は増加の傾向にあるとの見解に達しております。
I wonder why so many.
以上、BBC からお伝えしました。
Okay, now we've had enough. Now I'll talk to this guy. What is it? Something bothering you? You mind if we talk? Jonathan says. Yes?His background. Your skin looks a little... It's always like this, yes. Why is your skin that color? Because of my artificial blood, my red blood cells are actually white. White blood. I use first-generation artificial blood, which is less complex than the third-generation kind you see on home. Are you from beyond? Yes, I was born and raised there. I had a family matter to attend to on home. And yourself, Redwood says? Are you a terrestrial? Not exactly. I used to be an amphibian. You know, going back and forth between home and beyond? An amphibian? You were one of the amphibians? It was a long time ago, back when we were called astronauts. It might not make much sense to terrestrials, but beyond is home to me, Redwood says. His job. First-generation artificial blood. Are you in the military? Something like that, yes. I am a frozener, after all. You must be a pretty busy guy. My job isn't that remarkable. Frozener. Well, I guess we can ask about that. In a minute. Beyond. Redwood says, if you're going to Beyond for a sex vacation... What? What gave you that idea? I think I know a place you'd like. It's called Kabuki Quarter. Beyond is a very nice place. It has 1G artificial gravity and its own plant life. Terrestrials enjoy it a lot there, too. There's nothing else for me to say. The stewardess mentioned everything. We're approaching its 30th birthday. There are festivities going on all over Beyond to mark the anniversary. Frozeners. What do you mean by frozener? A frozener is someone created from an artificially fertilized egg held in cryogenic storage by the government, or the breeders, as we call them. The egg is later transferred to a surrogate mother for gestation and delivery. Oh yeah, I've heard a little about them. There's still a severe manpower shortage in space development. You sound like I'm boring you, Jonathan says. All frozeners have an identification code like this tagged into our foreheads, surprising as it may seem. There's a great number of frozeners on Beyond. There's no discrimination against us on Beyond like there is on home. If anything, we're considered superior. Artificial blood. What does artificial blood... having artificial blood do for somebody? Artificial blood has a higher oxygen transportation efficiency than normal blood, so it makes heavy blood loss less of a life-threatening condition. The body's functions aren't negatively affected in areas of low oxygen density either. Yeah, that's perfect for people working in space. So why hasn't it been adopted for widespread use? A normal person's kidneys and lungs wouldn't be able to process this type of artificial blood. You need to make slight improvements to the kidneys and lungs via genetic modification and also undergo regular hemodialysis. That requires incredible amounts of money and the proper facilities. Jonathan says, guess we can't really expect the public to be on it anytime soon, then. Arrival time. When are we going to arrive? Didn't you just ask the stewardess about that? You know, I can understand why you're nervous. It's completely natural, Redwood says. Beyond isn't much further now. We've asked about everything, actually. Show him the Hojo photo. I'm sorry, who are they? I don't know them. Yeah, I wouldn't expect you to. They look Asian. Are they famous? Are they Japanese by any chance? Why do you ask? There's a lot of Japanese in space. And nearly all of them are connected to Tokugawa. Is that your wife? No. Oh. So is she your girlfriend? Something about her reminds me of the woman from that other photo. I guess the ages are too far apart, though. Oh yeah, he's looking at the photo of from Hojo when she's older with him. That photograph looks really old. Hey, is that date correct? Yeah. Are those the capsules the stewardess gave you? If those are for SAS, I don't need any. I'm a Beyond, so I'm alright. I think we're trying to offer him capsules. What kind of leaf is that? Is that from a terrestrial plant? Ash, a Policenauts photo. A Policenauts photo? Why am I not surprised? You see that about as often as that emblem. You must have a real thing for them. Really, no one recognizes him in the picture. Now virtually anyone can go to outer space.
そうですね。宇宙酔いも楽になりましたから。何かあれば起こしてあげますよ。それじゃあ。
I don't know if we should trust that guy.
お疲れ様でした。当機は間もなく、ビヨンドコースト宇宙港に到着いたします。到着ロビーにて、国際宇宙検疫制度に従った消毒殺菌、入国手続きをお願いいたします。なお、ただいまジュースと食塩錠剤をお配りしております。フライト中に体外や流出した体液を補給するようご利用ください。
Beyond Coast, we're here. Yeah, we'll save. Insert disk 2. I guess I'll cut it off here. I could load my save and then figure out how to switch disks on this. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.